நான் உங்களை வெல்கம் பண்றேன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட். குட் மார்னிங், வெரி குட் மார்னிங் டு எவ்ரி ஒன். ஸோ ஐ திங்க் ஆல் ஆர் சேஃப் அண்ட் ஹெல்த்தி. ஸோ ஐ வில் ஸ்டார்ட் வித் அ சிம்பிள் கோட். லைஃப் இஸ் ஷார்ட், ஸ்பெண்ட் இட் வித் த பீப்புள் ஹூ பிரிங் அவுட் தி பெஸ்ட் இன் யூ, நாட் தி வர்ஸ்ட் இன் யூ. It's my pleasure for me to invite our department of EEE, head of the department, and also all the students. I request HOD ma'am to address the students. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Jayudhya. Good morning, students. And good morning, Jayesh and Harishwar. Going to present the webinar session today. And first of all, I would like to thank the organizer, third year coordinator, Dr. Jayudhya, as well as the alumni. Almost they must be the alumni now, but due to COVID-19, they are now in the final year. I would like to welcome that students, as well as I would like to thank that students, Jayesh, Prashant, Hari, Ishwar, Arvind Kumar, Arun Kumar, Bharat, Marisami, and one more alumni, Christo, and all of them have accepted our invitation in this COVID-19 in order to help you people and the pre-final year students for this pre-placement talk. And they are going to give you a great thought, that is whatever the opportunity available for you after this lockdown release period. So whatever doubts you are having, you have it as an interactive session, and you can have the clarification of your doubts. And I also wish all the students, the pre-final year students, the bright future after the release of lockdown. Don't demotivate yourself. You don't think that since you are in this period, what will be your placement opportunity or what will be your future. It's not that. This take care of your health as well as your family members, and you have to enhance your knowledge. You are already having so many busy schedule, like we have Wipro PRP program each every day. And I would like to congratulate the 25 students who have been shortlisted for the SkillTrack Elite program. Since they have done the programming code very well, the top programming code companies, for that they have been selected and shortlisted for the SkillTrack Elite program. And for that, students also all the best. Apart from that, you are having ERP program each and every day, 6 to 9 SkillTrack test. And I would like to that is appreciate all the students that you are cooperating very well in the lockdown to the counselors as well as to the year coordinator in all your activities, that is academic as well as placement activities. And we expect the same cooperation from you people throughout the period until we are going to meet in the college. Okay, so all the best. And one more thing, I would like to congratulate your batch, because in your batch only most of the students doing the programming coding very well, and the number of count shortlisted for the elite program also very high compared to all the other departments in our college as well as in the group also. So I would like to congratulate that students, and as well as the other students also. You are having the capacity, make use of this kind of training in order to that is get the opportunity for the better company in the future. So okay, all the students, and I would like to convey my thanks to the Jay Harishwar also on behalf of you for going to present this session, as well as your coordinator. Once again, I am appreciating all of you Thank you. Now I am handing the session to the organizer.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your brief introduction, ma'am. I would like to take this opportunity to invite J.S. Prashad A. TCS is going to give brief topic regarding roadmap to your future. Welcome, J.S.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Hello, good afternoon, everyone. I hope you can all hear me. First of all, I would like to thank everyone to take the opportunity to come and attend this webinar. I hope this will be useful for you in your campus placements as well as in your future. And let's directly dive into it. I hope everyone can see my PPT which I'm sharing right now. Okay. So first of all, about me, right? This is J.S. Prasad. I'm from final year. I'm just 1 year senior to you. Okay. So this, I call it as roadmap to your future, because it's important that this way of faith which you are going to have will be very important. Ma'am, HOD ma'am, would you like to say something?
You continue, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thanks. I'm hearing voice from HOD ma'am.
Okay. No, no problem. You continue. Continue.
Okay, ma'am. So, see, first of all, I would like to begin with a note that we are undergoing a situation of crisis right now, a pandemic like COVID-19 is happening throughout the globe. I just want to give a brief helpline and the prevention which you can actually do, which you have already know. I just want to repeat it once again. So make sure that you cover your face, nose and mouth totally, so that you avoid this disease. Okay, wash your hands very well. Be safe first of all, because it's not a normal thing to go out right now. It was happening earlier. Okay, please be safe and take care of your parents and grandparents who are living with you. Okay, not only for your health, but it's also for the parents and grandparents who are living with you. Okay. So by that note, I would like to begin this session. Okay, so whatever I'm going to show you, it's going to be like, it is from me, right? So in order for you to understand why I did this, what all the processes I had in the campus placement, it's important that you know about me first. Why I did take that decision, why I made this progress, why I got lost, why I won that. Okay, in order to understand everything, it's important that you know about me. So I would like to begin on that note. So about me, okay. First of all, I'm a biology group student in 11th and 12th standard in my school. So it is not a new thing for me to go into computer science and coding everything. Okay. So I had no knowledge about computer science in the beginning of the college. So I just had an interest in electrical circuits in my 12th standard. So I just went into that interest so that I can join electrical engineering. So by the way, I joined RMD. Just first year, just went like a school year, just focused on my academics, got a good CGPA, did well in exams, just focused on the academics. So going on forward, I entered into department by the second year of college. I came to know about all the opportunities we had. But first, what was struck me was GATE, okay? GATE, I hope everyone knows, it's Graduate Aptitude Exam for engineers, okay? So it has the opportunity to pursue masters or PSU, pursue masters or join in any PSU as government job, okay? So I had this option as my baseline, as a option to pursue as a career in my second year of college, joining by the second year of college. But at the same time, okay, I also grew interest in programming. So we had, C programming in our first year. By the way, you guys, since you are from Regulation 2017, change just after a year.
அது 3000 ரூபாய்க்கு ஆனதுனா இஎம்ஐ போட முடியுமா? ஏய் நான் ஏன் நம்பறேன்.
Yeah, I would like everyone to mute, please. There's some disturbance. Okay. So, first year we had a programming language called C, which we had in our syllabus, unlike you, who you had Python as a first language. So, by doing the syllabus of C, you know, I actually was very much behind the schedule since I was a biology group student. I couldn't understand probably the way in which how to write a code and everything. I gradually studied it. I went through the syllabus. I went through a book, and you know, I got to know about few things about programming. Wrote a good program, and I went for the exam. I did my best in the exam. I thought I would be getting, you know, an A grade or S grade. A grade means 80 to 90, and S grade means 90 to 100. And like you, you have 4 and S grade. So In C programming subject, I got only C grade, actually 60 to 70 marks. Okay, even though how much ever I could give the best out of me, it still remained a question that I didn't, you know, clearly went through the syllabus. I didn't focus on the C subject properly. So since it went as a opposite to what I wanted, I thought, okay, then I should practice even more. So that's where the skill rack part came in. Okay, so skill rack, going, everyone would have told you to go and purchase skill rack, go do coding in skill rack, go for webinars, attend webinars in skill rack, practice everything, do daily challenges, daily tests, and you know, try to improve your coding. So I thought, why not do it? Okay, so I just went for it. I practiced C and Java from the SkillRack portal. I now have 3 silver and 1339 bronze medals right now. So I just wanted to mention this so that you know what is the current situation right now. What is the current situation? So okay. So what happened next was that since I got my programming right, okay, I practiced a lot, I could write any program. If it gives me an input and an output, I'd be able to write any program given that. So there was a normal competition in SkillRack for KPIT Automotive COE, which happened first, which I cracked very easily. I joined in KPIT Automotive COE first of all, and then we got an opportunity to even attend a competition on Big Data COE as well. So I tried, why not? I thought, why not attend this also? So I went for Big Data COE also. I did it. It was pretty easy, okay? Not like Big Data. So we had an option. I got selected in both of it. I first joined in KPIT or then KPIT when I received a call that I got selected in Big Data COE as well. So going on to select, we need to be in only one COE at present, right? So I just went that, okay, see, the big data, it seems like it's the current tech is happening in the world. It is said by all principals and stories and even that. So I thought, why not give that a shot than KPIT Automotive. So I thought I will go for big data COE. And by the guidance of the mentor, the COE coordinator, everyone, we were given some tasks which we have to do to the courses we have to pursue. So we were told that we should pursue courses from data camp for machine learning and AI, and also by Coursera from COE. So I thought, why not give that a try? Something a new thing which we are totally out of. Okay, I'm from a triple E department. I don't necessarily have to do something from computer science. But I thought, why not give that a shot? Okay, so I went for it, pursued data camp, did all the courses which are present, and I thought, okay, this is good. By the way, the data camp totally had courses only on Python and its libraries for machine learning. So I got introduced to Python as well in that data camp course. So I thought it seems like interesting. we can do so many things out of machine learning. So why not implement that as my career option? So I totally went in for machine learning, got interested in Python, did many projects from that. So this was my level of experience till I went for placement. Okay. So coming to placement. Okay. My placement went like this. Okay. Just after third year, we were having a Zoho internship campus portal, a campus coming for Zoho. So there we had an option to get into Zoho before in the fourth year, seventh semester, so that we can have an experience of about 2 months and, you know, even get a stipend finally and learn something. So I thought, let's give that a shot and went for it. I got eligible by the Silvac medal, the AMCAT score, and the CGPA, which was, you know, as a criteria, which was present there. I'll be saying more things about criteria in the end of the session. So Zoho internship. I will be explaining the process of Zoho, Coda Global, and TCS in this webinar today, since these three are something which is specific to me, and I went through the last round of that. So other companies like Soliton, Econ, Switzer, and DeltaX, I will be showing you a brief about it, okay? So this was my placement flowchart, okay? I can say it's a flowchart. So first I got rejected in the second round of Zoho internship, so I couldn't pursue Zoho intern. Second, the campus started at the very beginning of seventh semester, okay? So we had Soliton coming as the first day zero company, and I went for it, gave that a shot, but I could only get to second round, I got rejected. Then at the Zoho campus, went till the final round of the Zoho campus, went till the interview round, but couldn't clear it. And then came Coda Global, which was a green category company, and even in that, I got rejected in the final round of it. Then came Econ System, which is a core company. Even in that, I got rejected in the third round. And also in Switzer, it's also a core company. It is a German-based company having the allocation of Switzer. And even there, I got rejected in that. In DeltaX, okay? In DeltaX, I got rejected. It is a web programming-based company. Even there, I got rejected in the first round. Okay, these all rejections happened in a so short period that I couldn't recover myself at all. So I went for it, thought what I need to do, was I doing everything right, why is this going all the way down, why couldn't I get selected in the company, even though I did everything I can, even coding, companies, practicing, everything. So there came a question, okay. Then came HCL, okay, they had an eligibility of 8.5 and above at CGPA, okay. So I gave it a shot, it was a quite easy process, I would say, and got selected finally, okay. So what happened exactly in these companies, which I'm not going to deal on the total explanation, okay. Soliton, okay. I'll be shortly saying what happened exactly with me in order for you to understand what went wrong for me. Okay, I hope you get that. So I'll be talking about Soliton first. Soliton is the first company on the day zero to come in final year starting. So I was excited for the first round. There were around 10 to 15 questions from quant and 12 physics. So since it was very easy for me, and I like problem solving very much, so I thought why not give it a shot. So I completed the whole paper, you know, it was just 10 to 15 questions, it won't take even a half for me to complete. So I completed within 40 minutes and gave the paper back, okay. But after giving, I revised 2 or 3 times, but still after that I gave the paper back, I told her to take it, I finished it. But what happened was, after that I realized I made a mistake in 12 physics problem. So I couldn't, you know, go for get it back and, you know, correct my mistake. I just went with it. Even doing that mistake, I got selected in the second round, which was a coding based round. Soritan will be totally explained by Harishwar tomorrow, I believe. So I'm just going through a glance in this. So there was a coding in C programming language. So I was doing that, and simultaneously I was called by the Soliton CEO, and he was asking me about my resume and the project which I have done. But since I was coming from a computer science based COE and practicing computer science as a major thing, I didn't focus much on the project or code. Okay, I just did one project in code with Arduino, and I was asked a lot of questions about Arduino, the input output pin and everything, but I couldn't answer the exact specific correct answer which they required. Even though I completed the coding, I completed two programs that were given to me. I passed all test case. I was not selected for the next round. They came to me and told that I was rejected and you can go. Okay, this was the process which happened later. My first mistake I did was I got excited for the first round, finished within time. I couldn't do projects based on code. I didn't prepare well, okay, since it was the first company. The second one, econ. Well, econ was totally different. It only had problem-based approach on core subjects like EDC, DSC, and LIC. So even there, I did my best, but still I couldn't go further because, I was not that much capable enough to solve problems on a hard level in subjects like this. Coming to Switzer actually is a German-based company having leadership. It had 8-year WARM. It also had integrated master's degree, which we need to do in Germany. Okay, so I didn't get into second round. The first round had actually quant, max, and coding programming, which was there in the first round. It had a lot of questions, around 100, I think. We were given around 2 or 3 hours to complete the whole paper and go into second round. There, I couldn't get into second round from the first stage. Okay. Coming to Delta X, it had an online assessment in the first round with JavaScript, HTML, and Python as coding. So there, they were only focused on very few second round participants. They were selected around 5, I think. Only 5 went into the second round from our college. So I didn't get selected in that also. So these were something which is beyond the scope of this webinar. So I will be dealing with the process which is happening in Zoho, Coda Global, and TCS. So what happened after HCL? I got selected in HCL, right? So after these many rejections, I got selected in HCL. The HCL prize will be shared to you in another session by our four-place candidate in HCL. So what happened after that? I got less burden. I got free. I could concentrate on my 7th semester exam, my syllabus, everything. I got my mind relaxed. Okay, there was no problem with me. After all these rejections, I thought I got placed somehow. I was happy. Okay, but at the same time, I was thinking again and again, what's happening right now, or am I doing everything right? So coming, seeing HCL, it had a salary package of around 3.5 lakhs, okay, per annum, and a 15 month bond. Okay, so it was okay. It is like a normal company, normal person who goes into a software company will be getting the same salary, right? And there were separate domains for HCL, which will be explained in a later date. I got selected in an aerospace domain. Okay, the event which occurred after HCL, after I get placed in HCL, was totally different. There were if you have the habit of reading newspapers, last year June there was lot of crashes from Boeing 737. Okay, Boeing 737 actually had a bond or agreement with HCL to prepare the software that required for flight departures and arrivals. Okay, so at that time it was kind of a bit tricky for HCL to get into aerospace domain specifically. I had an interest in aerospace domain because it was exciting. You'd be be doing flight simulation and something like that. So I thought, okay, something is wrong with it here. I thought it would be going over. But again, it was not, I was not feeling that much happy after that. Okay, what's happening right now? I know my potential, okay? I know my worth. I've done these many sacrifices, I've done hard work to get into some company, right? And coming to a salary kind of a criteria, okay? I'm back from a middle class background. So 3.5 lakhs per annum is kind of a same category for me, okay? It's not that much. And I thought, is this the limit I can go through? So I thought, okay, this is not, okay? This is something I have to overcome. I have to see for some other opportunities to go beyond. And also HCL had a criteria or eligibility of 8.5 plus CGPA. It was bothering my mind so much that why did they give us 8.5 as CGPA? Okay, see, all other companies will be maximum having 7.5 or even they have 6.5 as CGPA as criteria. I'll be talking about it later. But why HCL? Why are they having 8.5 CGPA? So my thought process was like that. They needed good talent people to work as their employees. So okay, talent is everywhere. Anyone can go into a role of that if they have some 8.5 CGPA. But I have something beyond that. I have some extra talents and coding opportunities which I can help in order to go for some other opportunities after that. So I was not fully finished. Okay, even though I got placed in HCL, my placement is over. I was not totally finished with my placement. That's in my mind. Okay, in our college, there is a rule that no companies further allowed in college after a single placement in course. HCL actually had even core as well as IT as separate domains. But I got selected in IT, and even if I got selected in IT, I didn't have the opportunity to get to the next companies visiting. There were companies like Amazon, Palmworld, which was coming next to us. Okay, but I couldn't attend that, even though they were big companies having a large CGPA. I will come to that later. So this was a criteria. So my college has done the right thing of getting me placed in a company HCL, but I was not fully satisfied. So I went for opportunities beyond the scope of college. I went to some other method. Okay, in online, I saw that there was an exam conducted by TCS called the TCS NQT exam, National Qualified Test. So I that was the eligibility for attending their placement round. TCS was actually, at that time, they didn't come to colleges. They were having actual level-based exams to get into their company. So I thought, why not give that a shot, okay? So finally, I will be explaining the process which happened in TCS later. So I finally, what happened, the result. The conclusion was that I got recruited in TCS. And that too a digital category as systems engineer. Okay, the role is systems engineer having a package of 7 LPA. So seeing 7 LPA, it's the double of what HCL offered me previously. Okay, so after what happened was I got an opportunity to go into an internship with TCS in Chennai for 5 months in computer vision and artificial intelligence, which completed by April 2020. So what happened after HCL was that HCL placement automatically got cancelled, since this was a dream category based company which I got selected into. So they chose the TCS digital offer for me and the HCL. Okay, this was whatever happened till date. So I will be explaining each and every company. So today my focus will be on Zoho, Coda Global and TCS. So coming to the general eligibility for all companies. Okay. As I said previously, the minimum CGPA requirement of generally most companies is 7.5 CGPA, okay, until what your semester is. Sometimes, companies go broad-minded and they give 6.5 as a category for CGPA, except HCL, they ask for 8.5, okay. But coming to arrear point of view, mostly every company which came out into our college was having more standing arrears as a criteria at the time of recruitment. Some companies rarely had a maximum of one standing arrear allowed. Okay, so even history of arrears, I would say they didn't allow history of arrears for some companies. Some companies had the option of history of arrears being one at the time of getting into placement. So coming about our going to our department, the major concern about four companies is that they are very few. If you can see, go through the whole internet and find some core companies that are present, the reputed companies will be very few, or there will be a lot of companies which are having, at a medium package size, one. Coming to software companies, there are a lot of software companies which actually. I would not like to go through the list of them, but they give preference to CSE, ECE and IT background students. Not triple E or E&I. Okay, so CSE, ECE, IT being the favorite among these software companies, we didn't have the opportunity to attend software giants like Amazon or Commvault. They have a package of around 14 and 20 lakhs per annum as a package. Okay, only CSE, ECE, and IT were allowed to attend these campus placements. So, see, triple E being from a triple E background doesn't mean it's a negative thing, but if you don't have opportunity. Yes. Yes.
Hello.
Who is it?
Just a second. Like, I would like to put a thought of mine in it. Commvault, actually, we were allowed. You remember?
Okay.
You were in your internship.
Okay, fine. Okay.
Okay.
See, even though we were allowed, we didn't get selected. No one got selected in Commvault. Okay, it had a large, requirement of coding practice, and their process was pretty much difficult. Engineering. It had Python actually. I don't want to get into that. So understand that this is what I want to make you understand, that the opportunity for triple E is being limited, and the time of crisis like this, like COVID-19 and all these things, the requirement of companies will be coming will also be limited. So understand the situation which is going across the globe. Okay, the opportunities are there. Okay, it's not that there is nothing. There are a lot of opportunities, but it's going to get reduced in the upcoming future. So understand where the globe is going. Okay, so coming to our process of webinar. These are all something which I wanted to make you understand so that I can go into company process. Coming to Zoho. Okay, so Zoho was the first company to visit before SurveyCon. Actually, they came for internship as first thing. And the second one was after SurveyCon, they came as a campus visitor. Okay, so we have two opportunities from Zoho. Firstly, as an intern, later as a campus recruit. Okay, so the first opportunity will be of intern. Okay, it will be happening after this crisis is over. I believe they will be coming to our campus and giving us campus recruitment for internship role. So for internship, okay, the process remains the same for both internship as well as the campus recruitment. For internship, I just give you an advice that go with full effort. Okay, there will be no competition because not everyone will be attending the intern part of Zoho. Okay, you can actually get into that easily. Okay, if you have good classes in programming, you have been versed with solving problems. Okay, so once you get there as an intern, you also will have an opportunity to get into a full time if you do well in the internship. Also, if you couldn't give your best in internship, still there is another chance for you as campus recruitment. You'll be visiting again. So at that time, you can maybe improvise and give your best at that time. So process remains same. The process is like this, okay? For Zoho, they give chance for almost everyone to attend, okay, attend the placement process. you have no arrear criteria. I believe there is maximum one arrear as criteria, standing arrear. Other than that, there is, I believe, 6.5 as CGPA eligibility. So it includes most of everyone who are at the college. Okay, so process is like this. There is first written round, which includes coding, snippets and quants. Okay, from written round, the next round is programming round. Around 50% of the candidates who attend written round will be selected into programming round. It will have maximum of 2 or 4 questions, from ranging from easy to medium as the criteria category. Okay, so the next, if you get qualified, if you pass all test cases, explain to it properly, you will be next given a chance to attend advanced programming round. You'll be having maximum of two programs of hard to very hard as a criteria, okay, as a category, sorry. So after getting advanced programming round, you will be having technical HR round and general HR round. Mostly they will be both same, and around 5% of the total candidates who got the opportunity to write written round will be attending the technical HR round, will be there. Okay, it will include problem solving, some puzzles and algorithmic based programs for you to write it down. Okay, the main thing I wanted to say about Zoho is that at the time of us writing Zoho, we did not have the opportunity to write in Python. Okay, during Zoho internship, we were not allowed to write programs in Python. We were given only opportunity to write C, Java and C++. But we had the opportunity, okay, the students talked to the Zoho HR team and they asked that we wanted to do it in Python, and then they said okay in the campus. This is the second method. Okay, so going to my interview experience, which happened, okay, so the first round was intern round. Okay, it had the same as I said, quant, coding and error finding kind of programs to sort out. But the campus totally had only coding, snippets and errors. It was a huge bundle of paper to be solved in 2 or 3 hours. Okay, it was pretty easy. I would say easy to average kind of difficulty. So those who went for intern, I'm saying for the campus process, those who went for intern in the beginning, they were directly given a chance to attend the second round of the Zoho. Okay, coming to intern second round, I got selected in the second round. It was pretty easy. So the second round had an easy program to solve in intern process. Okay, it had I was given 2 programs. First one I did it pretty easily. It was quite a easy program. See, about Zoho, the importance is that even though you finish typing down the whole program, you can pass all test cases they will be giving, there is a need to explain every bit of code which you have written to the Zoho person who is assessing the program with you. Okay, so after finishing all that, I was given another program to solve, but I couldn't totally solve the program, hence I was rejected then and there at the second round of internship. Okay, internship recruitment. Okay, so coming to the campus round, the first round actually happened in the first day. It was the same like the intern process, just that there was no quant which was present there. There was only programming. So we went the next round. Results came to be pretty late, so we went for the next round the next day. So the same process, like we were given 2 programs to solve, but we were totally separated from a ordinary batch. Okay, there was a total different process there in the campus. So they separated a few of us, like say 5 or 6 of us, separately as a project specific role. Okay, I was included in that, and we were given a 2 programs to solve, which I did since I was improvised. There was a lot of period between internship recruitment and the campus visit. So since there was a lot of time, I improvised my coding a little bit, did the program pretty easily. Okay, it was kind of an average. It was not easy, Okay, the program actually was of medium difficulty. Okay, it took me some time, but I cracked it. I did the program, explained every single code of every single line of the code to the tutor, and then I was given, I was told to wait, and I was given the next round, the advanced programming round. See, coming to advanced programming round, it had a very hard problem for me to solve. Okay, I was given an opportunity to choose one data structure based program, another a basic logic pattern based program. But both of these were very hard, you know, it took me a lot of time to find what's really happening in the program. So I would like you to, you know, practice some questions of that. I will give you some links to, you know, practice that. So coming back to the question, so if you are given a hard problem like this, okay, what you need to do, what my perception is like that, so go for it. Okay, first read the program statement clearly, understand what is required, what's the input, what you need to do, what will be the output of this. Okay, and take a paper. If you will be given a paper to, you know, to take the calculation or write it down, so use the opportunity well. Write down what is required, how this is going to print in the compiler. Okay, so try to understand what will be going through the process of computer's point of view. Okay, and then go to solving the whole problem in the computer. Okay, so it was it took me some time, but I understood what's going on in the program, and I did it. I could clear some test cases, not everything, but still, since I could make them understand how I approached the problem, I got into the interview point of it. Okay, the next round was interview. The interview had some time a bit later that day, so I was asked for my resume. Resume based questions, which I did, the project which I did, my skills, my background, family background, everything. But surprisingly, there was questions from Arduino and PIC microcontrollers. PIC microcontrollers, I believe you will be reading about it in the final year. So even I didn't know what a PIC microcontroller is, since I was at the beginning of the final year. So I didn't know what was actually a PIC microcontroller, since I couldn't answer what it was, what they were asking me. I just answered it in a way that I knew, okay, answered whatever I knew based on the facts they were given. Okay, they also asked me a few logical puzzles, which I got actually excited. So since I like problem solving, I did it you know, pretty fast. I didn't think what's really happening, and gave that to, you know, the recruiter, and found that I made some few silly mistakes, and I was actually you know, face palm. Okay, so time utilization is something which is very important in any interview process you take. Use the time very carefully, go for it, utilize every single second, understand the problem statements given to you. Okay, so it went like that for me. Okay, unfortunately, so after that, after all these things, also I was given some algorithmic based questions, around 5 programs to be handwritten down in front of the interview. Okay, they were very tricky and involved me to think how to, you know, there were questions like sorting and, you know, arranging array, something like that. So I couldn't do it well and was asked to wait. Okay, so after a few interviews with others. We were all, you know, grouped together, and at that we were all disqualified, and no one was selected in that project. So the process seems to be a bit hard. Okay, every company you go, the process will be hard. They won't, you know, understand the situation you are in. Okay, be it the first interview you are going or the last interview. Okay, you need to have the proper self confidence in order to, you know, attend the interview. Okay. Don't get disappointed after an interview that you didn't get selected. Be sure that you did your best and go for the next opportunity. Okay. So coming back to this, see, Zoho also has a competition called Zoho Click Trick. Okay, we were given this in the third year, I believe it's not come yet to you, or maybe you have participated. I just wanted to remind you fact that there was a person from IT department who competed in this Zoho Quick Fix competition, and he got into internship with Zoho, and he got into a permanent role also in Zoho. So there is an opportunity which is lying beyond the focus of campus also. I just wanted to highlight this fact that there are a lot of opportunities beyond the campus also. So make sure you know whatever things are happening in companies also, so that you can compete and get into this easily. See, we didn't have any first round quant, programming, advanced programming, nothing. He just was asked to create an integration with the app so that he can, get into a, he can integrate that application with this Zoho Quick application. So it's just an API integration, which he did pretty well. So he got into Zoho as an intern, and he went on, he went for that. So he got selected as a permanent role employee in Zoho. So there are opportunities which is lying beyond the campus. So coming to the next company. The next was Coda Global, which wanted to start totally. Yeah. Coming to Coda Global, it has a salary package of around 1.5 to 8 lakhs per hour. The organization deals with cloud, full stack development, machine learning technologies. Okay. It has basically three rounds. Okay. First round is online test. It includes quants, verbal, HTML, JavaScript, WebTech, and some easy programs. So it's pretty easy if you can, if you have solved, practice these things. So you can, try it and give it a shot. So it was pretty easy for me. I went into the process mix. The results came out pretty late, actually. In the evening, we had a short interview, say a 15-minute interview, where I was, there will be an interview on the same day. And the next day, we had a 5 hours of programming round. Totally 5 hours, more than 5 hours actually. So we were given some task to do it. Okay. The interview will be based on resume, interest, and the technology which you are going to pursue. Okay. Okay. The first was the 3 to 5 hours programming round is actually consists of a task, an application basically. You need to create it. Yes, Rudramani, you can. I saw a hand raised from Rudramani. See, if you have any questions in between, you can ask me, okay? Ask any questions. You can ask me in between. Okay. If you have any questions, if you don't have any questions, you can ask. So coming back to the 3 to 5 hours programming round, we had it in the next day. It includes creating apps like Flipkart or flight booking websites, or coming to machine learning problem, we will be predicting some results from a data set which they are giving. So it includes these. It is actually based on the technology which you want to you have learned. Okay. Not like something which is beyond the scope of yours. Okay, you will be given a whole internet to access. You will be given. You can search anything you want, and you can prepare. Not, it's like an open book exam. Okay, not like you have to sit and prepare without internet or something like that. So you are given totally every possible opportunity which you are given, and you need to prepare something like that. Okay, so coming to my interview experience. Okay. The first round, it was online. It had quants, web technologies, programs. Okay, it was pretty easy. I did it well. I qualified for interview. I was asked for the same day. It happened around 5 or 6 p.m. in the evening. So I was asked about resume, my projects, and a single problem on data structure, on logic based. Okay, so since they came to know about me earlier, okay. See, all the companies will be having the interview at the last stage. But Kola Global was a bit different, okay? They had an interview before the test so that they can, analyze what a candidate actually has done, so that they can either reject or, take into account that he has done something and we can give him an opportunity to, next day to perform some application of that sort. See, since I was from a big data CYE, I was having a machine learning based SEO. So the next day we had a small talk of second round, how is it going to be? Like it will be three to five hours programming. He wanted me to, do a ML task, okay, machine learning task for house price prediction. It was an online data set. I was given a polynomial regression based approach. I hope you don't understand, but still, I'm just explaining what happened exactly in the Kola Global process. So I was given a house price prediction for future from using polynomial regression, using a data set and also visualize the plot which are given like that. So it held for about 6 hours. There will be in between meetings with the interviewer and how the process is going and what you have done, the visualization, how you have proceeded, everything. So it all got completed. I did it pretty well. I showed them that this was visualization. And after that, as I told, it was totally free. You can freely search the internet, use any tech you needed. Okay, they just needed results. So it was pretty good. So you can have an opportunity to do something like that. So I completed within 5 hours. I explained every process to the interviewer. And finally, okay, after all these completions, I was called away. And we had a casual interview with the team. And was asked about my interest. And they gave feedback and appreciation for whatever I did, which actually no company does, okay? They won't tell you why you are rejected or, what you did good, what you need to improvise. Everything which I've told is something which no company does. But Kola Global was totally different, okay? They asked, they gave feedback of my performance on that interview. They told the process which I did was good. We need to improvise in these things, these areas, okay? So it was quite a good experience, and they also had the feedback of how their interview was, okay, how their process was, where there's some issues in between, or did you have a good experience, something like that, okay? Since I was from a machine learning background, since I'm from Tripoli, I didn't have any experience in web tech, okay? Computer science and IT students have, their syllabus itself has, web programming languages like HTML, JavaScript, like that. So since I didn't have any experience on that, since Kola Global is totally a cloud or front-end full stack based company, I got rejected, okay? Because I didn't meet their requirement. Even though they said that I was good in this, it's just that they didn't feel that I was required for a role in that particular company. Okay, they wished me luck and they said that I got rejected. Okay, it was really a great experience. I did my best. I feel that's the thing which you need to take from an interview point of view after the interview. Okay? See, whatever happens in an interview, it's just how you come out of it. Okay, how you feel, how did the whole went. Okay. It's not that you got rejected or something like that. It's just that you did your best, okay? You gave all the willpower and confidence into that process. That it doesn't matter if you got rejected or not. Okay, it actually took around 10 p.m. in that night. Just wanted to mention the fact that interviews can go long in the night, okay? Fortunately, we didn't have anything like midnight or something like that. But the previous years, even RCDS had something like 2 a.m. or something like that. Okay, I just heard it from the placement officer. So I just wanted to highlight that also. See, interviews can go till 10 p.m. in the evening. Buses will be arranged by the campus or college, so you can go to your home safely. It's not a big deal. Okay, so I did my best. I was happy that I did good. Okay, I was not feeling bad that I got rejected or something like that. So I moved on from that, went for next interview and went on till I got placed. Okay. So coming to the important fact which I wanted to highlight. Okay. I got selected in TCS, so I will be sharing a lot of information regarding TCS as a major role. Okay. TCS being a huge company throughout the globe, it has 4.5 lakh plus employees. Okay. It's a global standard level company. Okay. There are two types of recruits for engineering graduates. Okay. The first one being TCS Digital and TCS India. Okay. I just wanted to you to know that these are the two categories in which you can go into. There are many other categories for some other graduates which I don't want to, you know, say about. So these are the two things which you need to remember, that you can go either into TCS Digital or TCS Ninja. Okay. See, the total recruits of TCS Digital in an year is only 1,000. Okay. On the whole India basis. Okay, in the whole nation, only 1,000 graduates will be recruited as TCS Digital, and the rest of them will be TCS Ninja. Okay, mostly on an average basis, the total recruits per year will be 40,000. Okay, per year in TCS. Okay, so this is, I just wanted to show you that this TCS Sirisery, Chennai, outskirts of Chennai. Okay, a wonderful monument, a wonderful building. Okay, coming to placement process of TCS. Okay, there are a few things that you need to do first in order to register for, you know, placement in TCS. Okay, see, as I told you already, TCS doesn't come to each college and recruit. Okay, they have a national level based exam which they conduct, and you need to register for it and attend it, and you can get selected for that. The first process is that you need to create an application in NextStep portal. Okay, the link is given there, nextstep.tcs.com. Okay, I hope everyone would have completed the application process by placement officer. Okay, you, after creating the application, you will be getting a reference number. It will be the reference number till you get placed and till you get it to the company. Okay, so the next process will be the submitting the application. After you create the application and filled it properly, you can submit the application for their, you know, referral case. Teachers will be referring your application and checking for, you know, any mistakes or something like that. And they will be taking into your profile into account of their placement category. Okay. Okay, you, after completing that, you will be expecting an online assessment round to be happening next year. Okay, since you are getting into final year, I believe in the coming months you will be having an opportunity to attend these MCTs around in February, I think. So, I just wanted to highlight the fact. I will be coming to it later. And there is also another portal in TCS called campuscommunity.tcs.com. Okay. See, after you create an application in NextStep portal, since you get a reference number, you will be allowed to access Campus Commune. Okay, the importance of Campus Commune is that there will be some competitions which will be held by TCS and some articles which will be really helpful for you to understand what's the process behind TCS, how to prepare for a TCS interview and everything. Okay, just wanted to know you, make you know that. Okay. So after that, getting an advertisement or getting to know that TCS is going to, you know, have an assessment on February, you will be allowed to register it. Please register it. Just have an experience, okay? Even though you are going to get placed in days, you know, just try to do it, okay? I'm just saying this because I saw Zoho recruits, okay? The persons who got placed in Zoho attending this TCS national level exam was conducted. It's just an experience, okay, assessment. You need not attend the interview process if you have got placed earlier itself. But still, it's just an experience. Just try to attend this TCS process. Okay? And attending the online assessment is the final. final process of that. Okay, coming to TCS Ninja, this is the basic category everyone will be coming under. Okay, there are two rounds. Okay, the first one is, as I said, TCS National Qualifier Test. It's a national level program. Okay, it's for 2 hours. It will be after you register, it will be you will be given a hard ticket and you will be asked to, you know, come and attend it in any TCS ION center. Okay, it's located throughout the city, or you can even participate in the some other city also. Okay, after getting qualified in TCS NCT, you will be receiving a mail saying that you are qualified, and you will be asked to attend a technical interview at TCS, any TCS office. If you are in Chennai, most probably it will be TCS Tirunelveli. Okay, the online assessment on the other hand, TCS NQT, will consist of questions from verbal, quants, programming MCQs, and an easy coding. Okay, we were having only C and Java as the only programming languages in the exam. Okay, I just wanted to know that. See, learning Python is okay. The syllabus got changed and regulations got changed. I really it's a good thing that changed the C programming to Python. Okay, but still you need to have touch on other languages too. Okay, that's where the online portals like SkillRack and other portals come into play. Where you can practice some other languages also and improvise on them also, because it will help you somewhere. Okay, it will help you in these kind of exams or some other exams you're going to give where Python is not allowed. Okay, mostly it is allowed. Okay, but since there are some companies which don't allow Python as a criteria for first class. Okay, and the interview once you get qualified in TCS, the interview will happen 1 or 2 months later. Okay, it will be consisting of general HR and basic technical questions and about trees and technologies also. See, if you can do well in TCS NQT, if you pass all those cases in TCS NQT, you will be assured of getting into technical NQT also. And also, if you perform well, it means you're just answering the question and being confident will directly let you get placed in TCS Ninja. Okay, coming to TCS Digital. Okay, it includes 4 rounds. Okay, the process is actually same as TCS Ninja. It's just that there are two extra processes which will be happening in between the first TCS entity and the interview. Okay, so the first will be the same, attending TCS entity with the Ninja candidates. Okay, you will be writing it down with them. Okay, the second will be if you perform exceedingly well in TCS NQT, that is, if you perform well in quants and programming, you passed all test cases, you will get a separate email from TCS stating that you have performed well in the TCS NQT, and they would like to attend. They would like you to attend TCS NQT too, which is happening a month later after TCS NQT. Okay, so if you give that, okay, TCS Digital second NQT test will be quite difficult. Okay, it will be difficult in the quants and programming MCQ areas. Okay, but the programming will be kind of easy one. Okay, it will not be a tough one, I assure you that. So coming to my process, if you cleared all test cases in coding, you can sure expect a call for digital interview in the first TCS NQT, the same day as Ninja interview. Okay, the interview process will be happening both for digital and Ninja at the same time, but they will be knowing what who is actually the candidate, either it is TCS Ninja or TCS Digital. Okay, see, they will be asking you in the interview based on your resume, the recent tech and the technology which you are assigned to. Okay, TCS Digital actually means that you are someone who stands out of the crowd. Okay, you know some recent technologies, you have done projects based on it. Okay, you have interest on it, and you know basic concepts of these current technologies which are happening in the market right now. Okay, they may ask you to write programs also in the interview, It will be very easy program. You don't have to worry about it. It will be followed by an HR and managerial interview. HR and managerial interview will be happening at the same time. Okay, there will be basic HR questions about your family background, about you, and basic questions. Okay, it's not a big deal. If you have done in all these criteria, now the TCS NQT, it's an easy one. You just have to clear the coding. Okay, and after TCS Digital and in the interview, you can expect a good result from TCS. Okay, they actually are the company who respects the candidate who comes for an interview. Okay, you will be assured, given assured placement in TCS Ninja, at least. Okay, even though you didn't get as Digital, even if you qualified from Digital to the interview and you are attending Digital interview, I can assure you that you will be get placed in at least Ninja category. If you perform well, maybe Digital category. Okay, so coming to my experience, okay. See, about TCS Digital, as I said, it was a pretty easy one in TCS NQT, the first one. The second one had actually a hard quants and programming MCQs, but it was pretty easy. See, the first one was pretty near my home, but the second one was, you know, in Tambaram. I had to travel a lot, but even though I traveled a lot, it was, it was in the afternoon, I think. So it was pretty warm and sunny, but still you need to relax. See, that's the main thing. If you are going to attend an exam, go before the time, you know, sit there, relax before you attend any exam. See, that's very important because you will be traveling a lot and you will be stressed out. So go before the time, have a seat, get some water, drink it, and relax yourself and attend the exam with your pen. Okay. See, coming to interview, I got selected. Got selected for the interview. The program was pretty easy actually. In TCS NQT 2, the digital test was pretty easy. It was very, it was a simple program. I did it within the given time limit and got selected for the interview. I passed all the tests. Okay, coming to the interview day. Okay, it happened both with the Ninja as well as the Digital. Both will be asked to come to TCS office on the interview day. Okay, I actually, unfortunately, I had to wait the whole day. I was given 1 p.m. as the time to, you know, come for interview, but I was asked to wait for the whole day. There will be names going by calling you for the interview process, but my name didn't even come in the screen at all. Okay, I went for the interview at around 7 p.m. in the night. Okay, so I went for, they gave me an allotment of 1 p.m., but I went for the interview at 7 p.m. See, they test you, okay, that's the main thing. Okay, if you are stressed out, why didn't they call my name? You need to have control of your mind, okay, that's the main thing which you need to do. See, it was pretty hard day for me, it was a tough day for me. I didn't have my lunch actually, so it was pretty big deal. But still, I went for the interview, had a fresh mind, got myself relaxed before the interview, okay. There were three interviewers. The first interviewer was the technical one. They asked me Python actually. He gave me two questions to solve. It was pretty easy. I wrote it down. Okay. They asked me about machine learning since I worked on machine learning from the point of view. They asked me accuracy, type, and the problem faced by machine learning. Okay. Coming to the HR, he asked me the family background. See, these people will be sitting together. Okay. They will be assessing you at the same time. Okay. Even though you are answering to, you know, the technical interviewer, you will be assessed at the same time by the HR interviewer. Okay, so the HR will be asking will ask you maybe about your family background, IT questions, general person, or the technology which you are coming from. Okay, the post interview. Okay, after the interview got over, it was around 8:30 in the evening. I came out of the scoring level office. See, I live in North Chennai, but the whole travel will be not difficult for me. I came back to my home or rest. But see, as I said in the last two companies as well, the thing which I felt was I did my best. Okay, it doesn't matter. But still, I was not assured that I will be placed. Okay, even I was in a dilemma that I may or may not be getting placed. Okay. So I went down for the next interview process, which was happening to be Wipro PRP, which was happening in our college itself. CypherOPRP is something of Java and you know, web technologies, okay, totally on Java. So since I had the interest, we were given some assessments to, you know, do in college itself. So I was preparing for that, okay. And Wipro was coming the next month, next week or something like that. And so since it was, I got selected in Wipro PRP also, I was asked to, you know, go for the interview process as well, okay. But I got a call from, you know, placement officer saying that you are not allowed to, you know, get into Wipro PRP because you got selected in TCS Digital itself, okay. And I just wanted to highlight the fact, I'm not bragging or anything. See, I just wanted to highlight because, the number of people who get placed in TCS Digital is very low, okay. So that's why I'm saying this. See, in the whole of the RMK group, okay, the whole people who went for TCS interview, the TCS Ninja, as well as Digital, it's around 300 plus people, okay. But I was the only one who gets selected in TCS Digital. The whole group itself, not RMD as well, but it's the whole group. See, because why I'm saying this, because even though you don't get Digital as a preference, if you prepare well, if you are current in the tech which is going on in the industry, if you have done projects based on it, and if you can answer any questions thrown at you from those techs, you can surely get into Digital, okay. Since it was the first opportunity for me, I just wanted to highlight you the fact that it is not easy for, you know, get into TCS Digital, but it is possible, okay. So moving on, okay. Also, TCS also has, you know, competitions. As I said, Campus Commune in the beginning. Campus Commune has, you know, competitions that are held every year, like TCS Code Vita. If TCS Code Vita also gives you an opportunity to go into Ninja placement, okay. And also Digital placement by, you know, it's an online competition. You have to, you know, do 6 questions, I believe, 6 programming questions, out of which if you can crack 3 of them, you will be asked to, you know, attend Ninja interview. Okay, the registrations are open right now. I just wanted you to know that. Go and register if you haven't done it right now. Okay, please register. It's an opportunity for you to, you know, get into TC. Okay, and also see, I know that today you will be attending also another webinar session from our senior, Puthukumaran sir. So he is actually a Google recruit. So I just wanted you to say that this also, like, Google is also conducting, you know, competitions online. You know, there are competitions like Kickstart, Code Jam, Hash Code, which are conducting every year. Kickstart is something which is very special, okay. They are conducted around 10 times in the whole year, okay. You will get an opportunity to get into Google itself, okay. I'm not joking. See, if you do well in Google Kickstart, it will consist of the programs, around 3 or 4 programs, okay. It will be very hard. Okay, I've tried it myself, but it will be very hard. If you need that kind of an exposure or experience and you want to practice it, want to know how questions are asked in Google, it's a very good opportunity to just go and try that. Okay, the link is given there, codingcompetition.google.com. Yeah, if you have any questions, you can, you know, ask me in the chat, okay. Since I cannot, you know, talk with you, you can ask me in the chat. I saw a raised hand by Amber. Yeah, please ask me in the chat. You can either text me to everyone or to myself. Okay. So you can get to compete on a global scale, and also you can get international ranks on where you stand in the whole world. Okay. And also you can get selected for a Google interview also. Okay. Okay. See. After this, these are just some advices from me, okay. So, the topic, like, why did I struggle, or did I really struggle in that, okay. So, I just wanted you to know these points before you go into placement, okay. These are very, you know, important points from me, okay. from my side. Okay, see, it is your life. Okay, it's your future. Okay, you need to choose the company which you want to work in. Okay, it's very important. See, getting into companies, it's maybe a big deal for everyone, but it's not. It's an easy job. You can get into any company. There are a lot of job opportunities everywhere. But which is best for you, it's you need to decide. Okay, you choose the company which you want to work in. Okay, don't let the company choose you. Okay. See, after getting placed, you know, actually I feel pretty happy now that I didn't end up in some other company. Okay. I got into a company where I liked, okay, I got selected in a company for TGS where I was working in, okay, all my college years on machine learning and AI. So you will get a chance, okay, you will get an opportunity to work for your own interest, okay. Just that you need to find the correct door and market, okay. That's the main thing which happens, okay. Opportunity always comes to those who seek, okay. You just have to find the right. Yeah, I just got a question from Jan Vishnuvardhan. Okay. What if we don't know programming so well? Is there any chance to get selected? Yeah. Very good question. Okay, see, as I told you, you have an option to get into core or IT, right? You don't have to, you know, get into IT only or software only. Okay, you have the option to go into core or IT. If you are really interested in software companies, it is very important that you know programming. There is no other way of getting into any software company without knowing any programming. See, that's why people are, you know, in our college, wherever it is, they are asking you to practice coding as a main thing, you know, so that at least you will get placed in some software company. Okay, there are, I will be saying a few portal, a few websites where you can practice, learn, okay, at the end of the session. Okay. I also got another question. I'll come back to you, Vishnuvardhan, later. Ashwati, okay. You are from an AI COE, okay. I'm not strong enough to do mini projects with them. Okay, regarding machine learning, I'll be happy to help you if you can contact me privately, okay. I'll be sharing you the details of my contact, okay, so that you can call or text me so that I can help you specifically, okay. This, I just wanted to make sure that everyone understand this. If I say something about machine learning, not everyone will be understanding. So those who are from an AI COE, I would like you to contact me later after the webinar or later at any point of time. Okay, I'll be very happy to help you. Okay. Okay. So I'll continue. Okay.
Jayesh, sorry, ma. Sorry to disturb you.
Sure, no problem.
Actually, the third year students having one more webinar program. That program starts at 1:30 p.m.
1:30, ma'am.
Yeah. 1:30 p.m.
I thought it's 3 to 4, ma'am.
Due to some issues, they have changed the timing, 1:30 to 3.
Okay, ma'am. I will surely finish this soon, ma'am. As soon as possible. See, I will be sharing you the contact details, okay? My name is Jay.
Yeah. You share your details, your mail ID, everything. Yes, suppose if they are having any issues or any doubts, na, definitely they will call you.
Yes,
okay?
Okay,
ma. Try to make fast, ma. Sorry,
yes,
ma. Sorry
no
to
problem,
disturb
no
you.
Problem.
Okay. Thank you.
See, I've shared my email ID and contact number. Okay, anyone can ask my doubt. If you don't have, you're not attending the webinar, then you can stay by and see all the things which I need to share. Okay, it doesn't matter if you get placed first or last. All matters is that you get placed in a good reputed company which you want to, you know, actually work for and live happily. Okay, that's what I wanted to say. This is a quote I wanted to highlight. Do something today that your future self will thank you for. Okay, do keep this in mind every day when you wake up. Okay, the general advices which I want to highlight is that create a LinkedIn profile. It's very, very important. Okay, go create a LinkedIn profile, update your skills and projects you have done in your college day. Okay, make sure you follow some, you know, companies, people in LinkedIn, so that you can know what's really happening in the whole world. Okay, how everything is moving on, what's the current tech which is going on, everything, every company. Okay, so learn recent technologies, be it core or software, doesn't matter. Okay, know it first. Okay, just know what are the current industries. If you are interested, then learn about it. Try spending some time with it. Okay, if you are really interested, then go ahead and pursue as a career. Okay, coming to skill rack, see, it's been said by many people. Even I'm repeating it again. Skill rack is very important. Those who ask me that you know, you couldn't you didn't know programming so well, I just wanted to highlight that. See, programming is something that's very easy. Actually, it's like cooking, I would say. See, coding is exactly like cooking. The process is the same. The flowchart is the same. You just have to go in progress. Okay. So skill rack helps in a way in order to, you know, code, practice and understand what basic things which are happening in the coding part of you. You can see that. And also the competition is very high right now. I saw the skill rack right now, and there are a lot of people from your batch, okay, even junior than you, second year, first year, who are doing skill rack very well, and they are scoring medals, they are practicing it very well. If you can see the skill rack main page, okay, you can see all the people who are, you know, present in the top list of top 300 or whatever, and you can see a lot of people who are from third year and second year. You can see how the competition is going on. So practice well. It's for your own future, I'm saying. Okay, coming to advanced courses, if you want to pursue something which is known throughout the world, throughout the globe, okay, pursue something in Coursera or Udacity. For learning some projects or something like that, you can go for Udemy. Also, something which is already told is NPTEL. NPTEL is something which is very important, I believe. Okay, if you, it's not important as to get a certificate. Okay, it's important to know what's going on in the course, to go through the syllabus, understand what they are really lecturing about. So it will help you really very much. Okay, and there are portals which I wanted to highlight, like Geek for Geek, HackerEarth, HackerRank. These are all programming websites where you can practice, compete. Also, there are competitions that are present there. And also, finally, I wanted to make sure you understand that, see, so social media and games are, you know, going beyond the control right now. Okay, I just wanted to highlight that it's your life you are living, okay, not some other life. So make sure you limit yourself in social media and games so you can practice this. Okay, regarding AmCAT, okay, personally, I didn't have any, uses from it, but it really helps you in finding
benefits.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Jesh, sorry ma, once again I'm disturbing you. They are calling the students for a Google Muthukumar webinar section.
All of them will be attending the Google session, or
all students ma, for all students only.
Okay.
This is
okay ma'am. Maybe I can do one thing ma'am. I can share this PPT after this webinar so that everyone knows. I can end this meeting.
No problem ma.
Okay.
No problem. No issue, sir. For a tomorrow section, we will discuss how to write the resume, everything.
Okay, ma'am.
After this, we will wind up. Sorry, ma. Sorry.
No problem. No problem. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Okay, one second. Let me thank all the organizing team of final year students. I hope that you all enjoyed the topic roadmap to your future. Sorry to disturb all students because of one more webinar already started. That's why we are stopping this session now. Sorry once again. We will continue tomorrow how to write a webinar. Thank you. Students, I request all the third year students, I request to attend the webinar on Google Muthukumar.
Yeah, thank you everyone.
Sorry much.